Now, writing paragraph has always been a hectic task for all of you. Most of the time we start writing paragraph and we do not know how to conclude it or what should follow next. Now, here in this session I have discussed how to write a good paragraph and what are the features of a good paragraph. Now see, if you look here, you see features of a good paragraph. Now the first thing is topic sentence. Second thing is supporting ideas. Third is adding details. And the last one is concluding sentence. Now, with the help of this paragraph, we are going to understand what does these four things mean. Now see, this whole paragraph is about Pokhara. First, I'd read out the paragraph. Pokhara is an amazing place to visit. Now, this thing is my topic sentence. Now, when I write a paragraph about a particular thing or a particular place, I have to add a topic sentence. What is this thing all about? So my topic is Pokhara is an amazing place to visit. Next thing is supporting ideas. Now, what are supporting ideas? These are the points that would justify my topic sentence. That is, the supporting ideas would speak about why I think this topic sentence is correct. So these are my various points, like Pokhara is an amazing place to visit. Why? First of all, it is known for its scenic beauty. Second, see these red, the sentences written with red ink. These are my supporting ideas of this topic sentence. Now, second supporting ideas is also Pokhara offers a range of adventure actions for the visitors. And the third supporting idea is, in addition, you get to visit exotic places within the city. So this is my main topic, and these are the points, main points, which support the topic sentence. Now, after that, what? Adding details. Now, these supporting sentences would not make my paragraph a long one. These would, if I write only the supporting ideas after the topic sentence, it would be a very short one. So I need to add details to each of the supporting ideas or the points which I've used to justify my topic sentence. Now, what are the points here? First supporting idea, it is known for its scenic beauty. Now, these are adding details why I think Pokhara is known for its scenic beauty. You get to see the clear views of snow-capped mountains like Annapurna and Dholagiri from here. The scene of the reflection of Makhapukhure peak on the waters of Fewa Lake below is simply mesmerizing. So these two sentences, the third sentence and the fourth sentence, supports or adds detail to the second sentence, which is one of the point supporting the topic sentence. Now, coming to the fifth sentence, also Pokhara offers a range of adventure action for the visit. Now again, this sentence is again a supporting idea for why Pokhara is an amazing place to visit. Now again, this sentence, you can go, why do you think it is, it offers a range of adventure action? Because you can go hang gliding, do bungee jumps, or take a boating trip activities for the visitors. So these examples again add details to the second supporting idea. Now again, third supporting idea, in addition, you get to visit exotic places within the city, right? Now, exotic places, which exotic places? See, again, I have given examples to prove, to show the exotic places which you can visit. You can explore caves like Mahendra Cave and Bat Cave, visit the mysterious Devi Falls or peer down the Eri Sethi Gorge. Right? So, the second last sentence added details to this, the third supporting idea. And finally, I have the concluding sentence which says that this makes Pokhara a truly amazing place to visit. I hope I have been able to explain you how to write a paragraph. Now, if I, this whole thing was about a place. Now, what if I ask you to write about a social topic like, say, child labor? How can you go about that? Now, my first topic sentence would be, child labor is a curse on society. Okay? Now, what would be my point supporting my idea? It deprives the children of their childhood. First supporting idea. Second supporting idea would be, it creates injustice in the society. And my third supporting idea would be, these two are my supporting ideas, right? And my third point would be, due to child labor, the future of a country is deteriorated. Right? Now, depending on these three sentences, the first one I said, first sentence is, it is a curse on society. Supporting idea, it deprives the children of their childhood. Now, you can write how it deprives the children of their childhood. They can't go to school, they can't study, they are forced to work in houses, right? They are not allowed to play. Now, these are the supporting idea which tells why children are deprived of their childhood, right? My second sentence was, okay, now let's change it. Due to child labor, children are being tortured. Now, you can write the various forms of tortures which are inflicted on children. That would be adding details to your second supporting sentence, how the children are tortured. Your third supporting idea was the future of the country is deteriorated. Now, why do you think the future of the country is deteriorated? Due to child labor. Now, child labor, as you know, it does not allow the children, it bars the children from getting education, and education is the basic parameter which upon which the development of a country is dependent. So if the population remains illiterate, the country would always be lagging behind. This would be your first detail, and you can also add other details. And finally, you would conclude the paragraph with a concluding sentence. In this way, you can write your own paragraph. I hope it has been helpful for you. Now, try writing the paragraph on child labor. Thank you for being in the session.